The following video was sponsored by the Greek American Heritage Society of Philadelphia, preserving and promoting our community's history.
The history of Greek music in Philadelphia starts here in Old City. Today, this neighborhood is home to Jefferson Health Systems, but a century ago, it was the settling point for immigrants that eventually became known as Greektown. The year was 1918, and rebetiko music, the underground music of Greece, known as the Greek blues, brought by the immigrants of Asia Minor, was sweeping the country. One problem, it was illegal to play and illegal to record. Did that stop the Greeks? No, they simply moved to America, and in that year, musicians Marika Papagika and George Katsaros recorded the earliest rebetiko songs in the United States at RCA Victor in Camden, New Jersey. Today, Greek historians claim that the song Minure from Smyrna, sung by Papagika, is perhaps the most amazing 3 minutes in Greek music history. And it was here, at the intersection of 10th and Locust Street, in the coffee house where George Katsaros sang, and then recorded his first song, Greek Pleasure, at Victor RCA in 1919.
Κάθε σαποτά ανωτή θα πούνε και θα είναι και να σπεφτήσει να σπεφτήσει.
And the rest, as they say, is history. Today, 100 years later, a legacy of Greek-American musicians from all over the Delaware Valley have contributed and performed the songs of Greece. Laika, Dimotika, Nisiotika, Rebetika, and all other types of Greek music from every mountain, island, village, and city of Greece have been part of our Hellenic journey in America. We Greeks, we love our music.
So, πήγαινα στο καφενείο και έβαζα, θυμάμαι τότε, ένα κόρι και άκουγα το τραγούδι. Και το άκουγα μόνο μία φορά και το μάθαινα.
Έτσι.
Ναι, μία φορά. Ήμουνα 20 χρονών και μισό τότε, 21 χρονών. Ότι στη Φιλαδέλφια είναι όλοι πολύ ωραίοι γλετζέδες και πετάνε πολύ χαρτούρα. Still, στη Φιλαδέλφια, υπάρχει η χαρτούρα.
I had heard Δημοτικά when I was a young kid in my grandparents' home. All I heard was Λαούτο, Κλαρίνο, and a wonderful singing. Κλέφτικα, Τσάμικα, Καλαμαδιανά. My dad, on one of the trips back from Greece, brought me a bouzouki. So I had a bouzouki, and I would play in these parties a little bit, whatever I could play, you know. But we'd have fun. Electrified me to see Aristides Morsos. Just the beauty of the instrument, but not only that, his virtuosity was just outstanding. I love the instrument. My friends and I like bouzouki music, but I kept on hearing cymbalum gypsy music, and I loved that sound, and that predisposed me. So when I heard Aristides able to do it, Aristides could play some of the Romanian gypsy stuff.
17, 18 years old, and fortunate enough through an interview process, I was asked to join the band, never knowing what I was going to experience, but it was 5 of the best years that somebody could have asked for. Wonderful bandmates, wonderful friends, even to this day, we're all still very good friends.
Who were the Georgettes?
I was George, and they named it after me. Actually, we were singing for St. George's Church, the choir. Αυτό ήταν ένα κέφι κάναμε, το κέφι μας βάλαμε, κατάλαβα. And then it became a hit, sort of. But they sound good. Το γενεκάκι που το έχεις ακούσει χρόνια. Όταν γεννήθηκε ο πατέρα μου. Βαγγελίτσα, Βαγγελίτσα.
Αγαπάω πολύ τη μουσική. Δηλαδή η χαρά μου είναι να είμαι με το μικρόφωνο στο χέρι αν μπορούσα και στην πίστα, μου αρέσει πάρα πολύ. Το αγαπάω λόγω ότι είναι μέσα μου από μικρό παιδί, γιατί όπως είπα ο πατέρας μου, τα ακούσματα που έχω είναι μουσικά. Έχω ξεκινήσει μαζί με τον πατέρα μου από νεαρή ηλικία, από 17 χρονών τραγουδάω το νησιώτικο. Το συνεχίζω, ερχόμενη στην Αμερική, τα τελευταία 10 χρόνια το συνεχίζω και εδώ, με το παραδοσιακό νησιώτικο.
We began to play local. In fact, we played at the first festival that St. Thomas had. I played guitar and I started young and after watching the Beatles play, I guess. Why do we get all the girls? Because they think, I don't know, we're going to become famous with a lot of money. That's
And Mr. Ilia Papadopoulos wanted us to have a band of different children, but they had to be Pontian. We played in the band house. When we had the dances, we played twice. And we were so happy, we thought we were such a big deal. It was a fun thing.
I have a contract that you created, I believe it's from the 60s. I'd like you to just take a look at that and tell me what you think, and if you remember it.
Oh, I certainly do. And that's my writing. $185. Wow. And that was for five musicians.
My grandfather's name was Athanasios Filippou. He was he went by the stage name of Zervas, which is in Greek means lefty. He played the violin with his left hand. He left me his violin, which was string for a left-handed person, and he recorded on a lot of 78 records that I have, Panhellenic records, Balkan records. I listen to his records every now and then. You can hear him vocalizing on the records.
What does it do for you?
It makes me proud I'm Greek.
Θέλω να τα πω.
Wow, really good. Why that song?
Well, that was one of those songs that I heard from a Dallara CD, and it reminds me. Brings me back then when I first migrated here and I was kind of depressed. And I do understand though, now that I'm older, why my father brought us here. And I do thank him for doing that because I never would have accomplished the things that I haven't in this country without our father doing that sacrifice, which I recognize. But yeah, that song brings me back to those years.
We were in Las Vegas playing and I met a young lawyer there. He was probably about 30, 32. And his wife was there, and they were from San Diego. And we started talking, and he says, well, I'm originally from Reading. And I said, oh, Reading? You know, we're from Philadelphia. And he said, oh, yeah. He says, what's the name of your band? I says, Sismos. He says, I don't remember because I left early. I go, well, I used to play with Atlantis. And he said, Atlantis? He said, did you play the Clergy Lady Conference and the Yale Conference in Philadelphia? In 2000, and I said, yeah, at the Ben Franklin Institute. He says, yeah, I met my wife there, he says, and we're married. Here's my wife. She comes over, and he says, hey, this is the band, you know, and then she hugged me and said, yeah, I remember you guys playing. You played this song, I forget what song, you played this song. That's when I remember my husband, and whenever that song comes on the radio, you know, I have fond memories. That's what it's all about. You know, we're the soundtrack to your life. You know, all these bands, whether it's my band, whether it's the Pappas Brothers, George Jordis, Paul Kariga, some of the other bands like Neokima and all that, all these bands performed at your baptisms, your weddings, your dances, your Greek nights, your festivals. You were having good times. They were always fond memories. We were the soundtrack to your life.
For more information about sponsoring or viewing the interview series, visit the Greek American Heritage Society of Philadelphia online at ghsp.org.